Hello, welcome back to Retail Outsource. My name is Seb, and today I'm going to show you how to link your raw email click and drop with WooCommerce or WordPress. So once you have logged into your account, raw email click and drop account, you have to go into settings, and from here you'll be able to see an option for integration. Click on go and click on this add new integration. Okay, you can see an option for WooCommerce. Click on that. Okay, from here, don't put your URL straight away. The next step is to go to your WooCommerce website. So I've logged in here. And then you have to go to, click on WooCommerce, and then you can click on status. Click on status. And you can see the link here. You have to select the site URL. Okay, so copy that from here. Go back to Royal Mail. Paste your link. Okay, then it will ask you to approve if you're happy with all the details have been shared. If you're happy with that, click on approve. And from here, we have to select download products data from orders. You can use the same billing address, mark orders as dispatch on channel, that means on WooCommerce. The thing to note is that if you even tick on this one, the tracking will not be updated straight away, same like that we have it on eBay, Etsy, or Amazon. Okay, with WooCommerce, it's different. The tracking will be added as a note to the order, and that will be sent to the buyer. Okay, so that's how it works. And the next send tracking as a note, you can see. So you can add a custom template as well if you want. And the next option is to add the customs details if you want. So if you are sending international orders, then ideally you want to fill the details over here. Basically, it's the country that you're sending. There are three attributes. So this is the custom attribute. So country of origin that you have to enter it. And then the next column, you have to enter the country of origin. That's the United Kingdom, for example. And the third column is for the boxes for the custom code. I'm not going to enter it now because I have different custom codes for different items. So I'm just going to leave it as it is. And then once you're happy with that, you can click on update and activate. And if I scroll down, you can see WooCommerce. And it says active. It's shown a screen. That means it's active. Let me know if you have any questions or comments. Thanks a lot for watching.